We're going for a little tramp round here. Of course, every valley needs a little tramp. Now, them woods there, there's a nice Hillfort up there, which used to, and I emphasise the word used to, have a cracking good view at the top. Now the view's still there, it's anyone's guess. I know the stones will still be there. Got a nice packed lunch with us, as always. Aldi's finest. We're going to crack on down here a bit, just past four pensioners, heading slowly back towards the car park. And there was two lads in a car down there, so I'm just obviously putting this on for insurance purposes. So the possibility of two perverts, /ruffians, degenerates, whatever you want to call them. I don't know if they were ramblers. They weren't wearing any gaiters. So I'll sign off for now. Little Donna in the College Valley. Ciao! You ever seen that film, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre? What's going on here? Luke just passed us. Well, I'm getting, he's a hillbilly. Hillbilly's just passed us. On a 4x4. Sorry. Because that's how we show off. Impress the local girls, I'll admit. Yes, he was quite good looking. But I'm sure I heard somebody starting up a chainsaw earlier. Obviously a little bit worried about that. This wasn't here last time I was here. That's probably where they take the victims, hang them up, skin them, make themselves new clothes out of the skin and stuff. Ooh, hold on. In there. Signing off for now. Bye. Slowly but surely we're getting there. You can see how steep that is. Swear to God, if any joggers, if any joggers come up past here, jogging past me on this hill, I would give them such a dirty look. Getting quite high here. Just going off memory, really. You'd think someone would have had the sense to put a nice bench or something here. Bit regrettably, decision to only bring two cobs out of the juice now as well. You can only swallow the spit in your mouth for so long. Now, did that used to be a sign? Is that where the hillbillies, like, crucify their victims, skin them, take them back down to the workshop, make themselves each Christmas presents? Bonjour, still got a little bit of a climb to go. Running out of spit, so I'll sign off for now. Tell you what it is, the ascent up here is that steep and treacherous. But in the winter, with a good pair of skis, even Eddie the Eagle wouldn't dare come down here. Now that's saying something. Anyway, I'm nearly at the top. I can see the path I want, forking off to the right, which pleases little Donna. I just wish I'd brought another cold apple juice with a bottle of water. I didn't bring my knife, I brought an extra double decker instead. Right, this place used to be waymarked, and now it's no way marked at all, so I'm going to have to go off memory here. This all seems very familiar. Obviously this is very familiar to you and quite comforting, unlike this, which isn't really very comforting, little Donna, all by myself here. Nice day for it actually. Got myself a nice packed lunch with us, obviously sponsored by Aldi. Brought a coat. I have to utilise my coat as a coat, because it can, well, that can get quite inclement out here in the College Valley. That's why it's called the College Valley, because you learn a lot about the weather. So I'm just going to go into the forest. Leave it out in the wilds of Wanny, and guess what I'm bumping into? A little best friend. Hey, hello, meet Waymarker. Hillfort Trail, Waymarker. Oh, chuffed beyond chuffiness. Look, it even shows us the way out. Aha! That's always an added bonus. Right, a bit like the apocalypse up here. Lovely forest though, nice feel to it. I'm having a good day. And obviously, whatever time of day or night you're watching this, you're having a cracking time too. I'll crack on, because I've got my directions. Easy for city folks, which is go straight ahead. Toodles! These folks, as you can see, this way marker. I think I need an x-ray machine for the work out without that pointing. Oh, hold on, I think I've just seen it. Might find it back here. Oh! I found the fort! I didn't come in this way last time. It's up there. Drop a little Donna. Found the first problem spot. Fact time. Donna Van Senior reporting from the ancient hill forest. Top of the College Valley. 2,500 before crunchies. Just going to find myself a little perch to sit on and enjoy me pack lunch. In fact, I might even take a picture of me pack lunch for you. In a bit, peeps! Rah! I'll show you around the Hillfort a little bit. Hopefully, you can hear us because of the wind. I'll just talk you through what the Hillfort used to be. So these stones here, I'll have to be careful with me, but these stones here sort of go around like that. So this would have been where they kept that cattle safe from the marauders. So this would have been the cattle bit. And then a bit further on, we'll come to the family games room. So over the cattle wall, there we can, over the cattle wall. See, you want to keep your cattle in like that. You got stuff like away from the dinner table. So this would have been the games room. They would have had a big fire here, yeah. Like back in the day, the walls would have been a bit higher. Then they would have had the fire on, and when it got dark, they would have made like shadow puppet type things on the walls. And that was known as your first fire stick. That's not an original idea from Amazon. So let's say this would have been the games room. Would have been quite a big family. So we've had the animal compartment, the games room, going on a bit. Oh, a bit of a hill here. Going on a bit. This would have probably been the dining room. Nice meals for lunch. Fix a tree there for to hang your washing on. So that would be the dining room and the laundry room. I'll take you into where the kitchen probably was. Oh, this looks like kitchen material over here.
Actually, this is kitchen material right here. But,
this would have been the kitchen. This is where they cooked all the nice dinners. As you can see, they probably left this at Christmas time because there's that train that would have had all lovely decorated with baubles. So this would have been the kitchen room. I think the bedrooms would have probably been round here at the back. The sauna and the toilet would probably be over here next to that Christmas tree. It's like quite a nice little pad for back in the day. Quite a nice little pad for now. I'm going to sign off. I'm all thinking of going up that hill there. Why not? Got the day off work and there's no one around. And I love that. I absolutely love that. I love it when it's just me out and about. Weekday. And look at that one. Donovan Senior reporting from the kitchen at the really old Hillfort. Top of the really tall tree. Christmas trees all around. In the College Valley. It might just for sheer kicks and giggles. Trot up that one in about a half an hour. Sign off for now. Ciao peeps. Bye. Donna, off trail. I thought I found a trail. Looks quite promising actually, isn't it? And I was like, oh, I should have used that one on the way up. then he would ramble up here, because I'm a mean lean rambling machine at the minute. There's no stopping us. Quite branchy through here though, so I don't know. I don't think this is a little path, because quite frankly I'm on my hands and knees here. Now you would have to either be a hobbit or B, working in the local circus for to be able to just walk under that nicely. I'm guessing these are rabbit tracks. Still the woods don't feel too bad. My god, what was that? The woods are starting to feel a little creepy now. Little creepy. Donovan Senior on her knees in the woods. It's been a long time since I can say that. Donovan Senior on her knees in the woods. Praying to god that she can find her way at the top. We got that one off nicely. Right, I decided to come out of the woods. Just got a little bit sketchy in there, so I thought I'll just follow the ferny heathery type track thing. That's probably not a track, it's just probably a deer run or something, or a rabbit run. It's a nice ancient forest back there, and I was grabbing on a fair few branches and they were snapping off with a nasty crack. In fact, it used to remind us of the time when I used to play arm wrestling with me nana. There's some noises you don't want to hear again. But I'm going to head on up this way. Probably not one of my wisest ideas ever, but I'm on a day out rambling expedition, so what could possibly go wrong? Looks a lot further to the top than advertised on the postcard, I'll be honest. What's life without an adventure though? A little bit sketchy here, folks. Once you get round the woods, there's a barbed wire fence. Need a bridge across the barbed wire fence with a broken branch. As I watch, programmes are coming handy sometimes. So I made myself a bridge with a broken branch. I've just got to go up here. But you've got to wonder to yourself, why is the fence cut off? Now earlier I saw some evil looking cattle over there. I don't know if they were girl cows or boy cows. So I'm hoping there's not wild cattle here. Because they mightn't be wild until I say I'm in that field, and then they might be really wild. But I'm guessing I could roll down this hill quite fast if I make it to the top. So I'm going to go for it. I'm going to go for the summit, and I'll speak to you when I'm up there. All right. Splashing out the dirt peeps, I've gone under 720p. OMG. Actually hard to believe you're in Northumberland with views like this, isn't it? I mean, look. Absolutely cracking good views. Tell you what, I'm going up that hill next time I come here and do that one. Maybe it's that one. I'm liking the look of that one though. But aye, absolutely fantastic. I've had a cracking good day out. I'm not going to do the walk I was going to do. I'm just going to go up to the War Memorial, have a look there, turn back and about the van. As I say, absolutely stunning around here. You wouldn't think it was Northumberland. You would actually think it was Paris Fashion Week. Pax, had a cracking day out. Weather's been fantastic. Been spoilt for weather. I've been spoiled for scenery today, honestly. Beautiful round here, and there's loads more to explore, so I'll be back here again. I would even feel quite happy doing a wild camp here, I'll be honest, up that Hillfort. It's fantastic up there, I love stuff like that. So yeah, heading back to the van, make a nice coffee, bake with slice, put some comfortable pants on, pair of trainers, take a nice drive back down to Newcastle. But for now, Donovan Senior reporting from the beautiful College Valley. Oh, he has a pensioner coming jogging past us soon. The beautiful College Valley
Northumberland. Ciao.